Hey, good optometry morning. Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor here, and today I'm telling you all about pink eye, what it is, and what you need to do about it. And we are starting right now. All right, so let's clear up one thing first of all about pink eye. Pink eye is not a diagnosis, it's a symptom. So your eye is either pink or red, and that's the color of it. It's kind of like saying, I have a sore arm, and saying to your doctor, hey doctor, I want to find out, do I have a sore arm? I'm really worried, I have a sore arm. Can you diagnose, do I have a sore arm? Well, yeah, you have a sore arm, but the question is why you have a sore arm. That's what pink eye is like. So pink eye is a symptom, not a diagnosis. And in actual fact, the medical term is called conjunctivitis, which means an inflammation of the conjunctival tissue. All right, so a little anatomy lesson. The conjunctiva is the loose, clear tissue that lies on the surface of the eyeball and on the underside of the lids. And it's a mucous membrane, and it's a multi-layered thin tissue, and it has lots of little tiny blood vessels in that tissue. All right, so if you have a conjunctivitis, what that means is that conjunctival tissue is irritated for some reason. When it gets irritated, those tiny little blood vessels, they will dilate or get a little bit bigger, and then that tissue will look a little bit red. Another symptom that you will often get is that those blood vessels will leak clear fluid, and so that whole tissue will look kind of swollen and a little bit puffy as well. And so when that happens, that's called conjunctivitis, and there's a whole bunch of different types of conjunctivitis, and the key is differentiating and figuring out which one it is, because they'll each be treated differently. So now one important thing that you want to differentiate it is whether your eye is red because it's inflamed because of conjunctivitis or if it's because you have a broken blood vessel. And if you have a broken blood vessel, kind of like I have right here, that's a whole different story. That's called a subconjunctival hemorrhage. And I've got a whole nother video all about that. And if you want to watch that, you can see that up here. But today we are going to talk about conjunctivitis. Okay, so there's three main types of conjunctivitis. There's bacterial, viral, and allergic. So first of all, let's talk about bacterial. And so the defining feature of a bacterial conjunctivitis is that it's going to have a thick, mucousy, yellowish type of discharge. And so it's going to cause your eyes to be kind of matted shut in the morning, really goopy and sticky. And if you have that kind of discharge, it's very likely that this is bacterial. So if you have a strong immune system, likely your body's going to be able to fight off that bacterial infection in 5 to 7 days. But oftentimes we might need to use some antibiotics to fight off that infection and help your body deal with that infection. Now there's some topical antibacterial eye drops that you can use, but there's a lot of bacterial resistance, and I find that a lot of times those over-the-counter eye drops may not really deal with these bacterial infections, and oftentimes we'll have to prescribe an antibiotic that will deal with this infection faster. So a key point that I want to stress about antibiotic eye drops, or any eye drops for that matter, if you happen to have old antibiotic eye drops from a previous eye infection, do not use them. The reason is because if those have been opened, bacteria can get onto the surface and inside that drop, and it can contaminate that drop with bacteria. And if you were using that with a previous eye infection, there's a very good chance that you touched your lid or your lashes or your fingers to the tip. And since the last time you've used that bottle has been growing and incubating bacteria inside and on the surface. And so if you start using that eye drop, you might be adding more bacteria to your eye infection. Okay, so the second type of conjunctivitis is viral. And viral is actually the most common type of conjunctivitis that we will find. And the symptoms you're typically going to get with a viral infection is that it's going to be a watery, kind of weepy discharge. And it's not going to have that thick, goopy mucus discharge like you'll get in a bacterial infection. You'll wake up with a little bit of crusting, but it's not going to be matted quite as shut as the bacterial infection. Now, there's hundreds of different types of viruses out there that can affect the eye and give you a viral conjunctivitis. The most common type of virus is an adenovirus, which is the same type of virus that gives you a common cold. And this adenovirus can infect the conjunctival tissue and give you a viral conjunctivitis. Now, other viruses, like even the COVID-19 virus, that can give you a viral conjunctivitis. And there's an even more serious virus that can cause an infection called EKC, or Epidemic Keratoconjunctivitis, which is much more serious because it can start to affect the cornea and can affect your vision. So let's talk about affecting your vision for a moment. So most conjunctivitis only affect the conjunctiva, and they don't affect the cornea, which is the clear tissue on the front of the eye. And so as a result, most of these infections will not affect or cause any risk for your vision. However, there are some conjunctivitises that can also affect and involve the cornea. And if they do, they are vision threatening unless they're treated and dealt with properly. All right, so what do you do for viral infections? So like the common cold, there's not really any medications that can kill and get rid of this virus. You mostly have to just wait it out, manage your symptoms, make sure you're not spreading it to other people, and just wait 7 to 14 days, and usually your immune system is going to fight that viral infection off on its own. Now, there are some eye doctors that may provide an in-office antiviral treatment of a low-dose betadine eye drop that can help resolve these viral infections a little bit faster, but most of the time, we will just let these run their course. Okay, and the third most common conjunctivitis is allergic, and the defining features of an allergic conjunctivitis is that it's going to be itchy, and it's going to typically affect both eyes, and you will often have other allergic symptoms that are affecting your throat and mouth and nasal passages as well. And so for treatment for these allergies, you're going to typically use oral antihistamines or antihistamine eye drops. It can be prescription or over-the-counter that can deal with those allergic symptoms. All right, so those are the three main types of conjunctivitis, but I'm going to tell you about some other types, and I'm also going to get to some really important information about conjunctivitis and how you treat and deal with it. But before I forget, if you have learned anything useful in this video so far, make sure you hit the like button down below so you can let YouTube know the value of this video. Okay, so there's a whole bunch of other conditions that can also cause different types of conjunctivitis. And you're gonna need your eye doctor to help you differentiate these to make sure you don't have one of these, especially if you happen to have a chronic red eye that doesn't seem to be going away. So these can include conditions that are related to contact lens wear. They can also include iritis or dry eye or any type of irritant that might be irritating the surface of your eye, including foreign objects or chemicals or pollution or things like that. It can also include certain STDs like chlamydia, gonorrhea, and even herpes. But all of these conditions can cause you to have a red eye that you'll need your eye doctor to diagnose and manage for you. Okay, so what should you do if you have a pink eye? I'm gonna give you five tips of what you wanna do. First of all, see your optometrist. They're gonna help you diagnose this condition accurately and get the right diagnosis and get you started on the right treatment so you can get the fastest resolution of this eye problem. Number two, you want to stop the spread. So if you have a red eye, and in particular, if you have a red eye that's kind of weepy or has any type of discharge, consider that that eye infection is likely contagious. And so you want to prevent yourself from spreading that to other people or to your other eye. And so what you want to do is make sure you wash your hands regularly. Try not to touch your face or your eyes. And if you do, wash your hands immediately after. Try not to share towels. Clean your pillowcases regularly. And make sure you disinfect commonly used surfaces like your phone, handles, keyboards, and various things that you would commonly touch regularly. Make sure you try not to spread this to other people. Number three, make sure you stop wearing contact lenses. If you are a contact lens wearer and you have a red or a pink eye, I want you to assume that that pink eye is associated with your contact lens wear. And you need to see your optometrist to diagnose what the true cause of that red eye is, because any red eye that's related to contact lens wear is likely affecting the cornea and is likely vision threatening. So make sure you see your optometrist. And if you happen to have an eye infection and you're wearing contact lenses, make sure when you put new contact lenses in that you put in new contact lenses and you start with a new case. All right, and on the same note, number four, if you wear eye makeup and you have some type of pink eye or conjunctivitis, assume that your makeup is contaminated. So you want to get rid of that makeup, stop using it, because makeup is a great medium for growing and harboring bacteria. Because once you get your eye infection cleared up and you start using that makeup again, you might just give yourself that infection again. Okay, and number five, keep your eyes clean. So if you get eye infections regularly, or if you want to minimize the number of eye infections that you might get, you want to make sure your lids and your lashes are clean. Now, all of us wash our hair and our face and our hands with soap, but almost nobody washes around their eyelashes and their lids with any soapy type products because they tend to sting your eyes. Now, there's some products on the market that are designed to wash your lids and your lashes and to keep them clean and they don't sting your eyes. And you can use these products every day to help keep your lids and your lashes clean. And I've put a link to them down in the description below. All right, so I'm glad I could help you out with your pink eye. And if you want to impress your optometrist, don't call it pink eye, call it conjunctivitis, and ask them, what type of conjunctivitis do you think I have, doc? And if you haven't done so already, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below so you can get more videos just like this one. Have a great optometry day.